Good morning, children. Hope everyone are good. Yes, children, in the last class, we completed the lesson Bammara Pothana, right? Reading second chapter, Bammara Pothana, we completed. And we are done with the chapter 3 also. Now, let us enter into the chapter 4, Reading an Adventure. Yes, before entering into the chapter, children, I request you to open your textbooks, page number 48, and look at this page sheet. Okay. So, look at the picture and discuss the questions that we have. So, there is a picture here, right? So, first of all, what can you see in that picture? What do you see in the picture? Tell me, children, what do you see in the picture? Yes. Here, there is one girl receiving the award. So, which type of award it is? Bear. Yes, at the behind of this person, we can see bravery award. In a sense, she is receiving the bravery award. Why do you think girl was given the bravery award? Yes. Why do the girl receive this bravery award? Because she might be done an adventure. She did a brave work. That's the reason why she awarded the bravery award. Yes? Yes. So description talk about the picture. What is there to talk here? Yes, she has done an adventure. So to praise her, to encourage her, even still to do the same in the future, they are providing a bravery award. So, to inspire other students also, by that girl, they are giving the bravery awards to her. Yes? Yes. Here is a policeman. In a sense, something regarding the police. Yes? Yes. So, next, reading here. Let us enter into the chapter now. Let's go, said Seema, or it will be time for lunch before we know it. Yes, let's go towards the old temple, said her cousin. As always, they had come to Vishnupur on a vacation to their grandparents. It was a small, quiet town surrounded by green hills and some ancient ruins. They particularly loved going for a walk and spent hours exploring the old temple in a fort nearby. Sometimes they pretended to be rulers of an ancient kingdom. At other times, they played hide and seek. Yes. So, Seema and Arjun. Seema and Arjun. These are the cousins. Okay, these two people are cousins. Okay, they came to their grandparents' house, Vishnupur. Okay, in their vacation. This is holidays, in their vacation. Okay, it is a small town, quiet town, which is surrounded by green hills and some ancient ruins. This is some ancient places. Some ancient temples, okay, decayed buildings, ruins in the sense, collapsed, decayed buildings. This is the buildings which are destroyed a little bit. Okay, old buildings. They particularly loved going for walks and spent hours exploring the old temple in the fort. In a sense, these two people come to their grandparents' house because they love to walk there. They used to go for a walk and they used to exploring the old temple. Since they used to roam the old temple near a fort. Okay. Sometimes they pretended to be ruler. In the sense, they used to think they are as they play, right? You are the ruler and I'm the person under you. Okay, they used to play. Yes, come do the work. In the sense, they used to play as a ruler. Thinking themselves as a ruler, they used to play the games. And sometimes they used to play. What they used to play? Hide and seek. Okay. They used to play hide and seek. Yes, here these two people, they are saying, Seema is saying, let's go. Otherwise, our lunch time will become. Let's go and pray for some time, she said. Then Arun said, yes, let's go towards the old temple, he said. Here now they came near old temple. So, catch me if you can, shouted Arun, and he ran ahead. In the sense, they started playing now. Okay, they started playing now. Then Arun said, catch me if you can. I'm going to hide now. And then he went off. I will catch you in a minute, replied Seema. She said, yes, I'll catch you in a minute. Arun was soon out of sight as he went round the corner. Seema knew his favorite hiding place and smiled to herself, thinking, he won't escape me. She ran down the hill towards the old temple where she knew Arun would be hiding. But he wasn't there. He must have gone to the cave, she thought. This was another favorite place for them. A cave hidden behind some creepers. Arun, I'm here, Seema called out as she reached the cave. Yes. So, Arun said, "Catch me if you catch." He said, "Had he went off." "Yes, I'll catch in a minute," Seema said. Within a minute, Arun was not, couldn't find. He went to the corner. He went to hide. So Seema said, Seema is laughing herself and said, "I know his favorite place where he is going to hide," she said to herself. "And he cannot escape from me," she said. So she went to her place, his favorite place. Where it is? Down the hill. It was in towards the hill. She went and she saw them. But there was no Arun over there. So she knew his second favorite place also. So she went to there. There is a cave behind the creepers. Creepers in the sense, plants, unwanted plants. Okay, unwanted plants, grass, everything. So it was behind that. So even Seema went there, but Arun was not there. "Arun, I'm here," said Seema. Seema told, by even he was not at his second favorite place also. So she shocked. So she called, "Arun, I am here. Where are you?" she said. There was no reply. Seema could not see anyone. She was about to enter the cave when she caught sight of a piece of torn, crumpled paper on the ground. She picked it up and unfolded it out. How odd, it had letters CLP written over it. See? So she called, "Arun, I'm here. Where are you?" she said. But there was no reply. So she was just to leave the cave. Then she saw a paper there, piece of paper finding. So she took that paper. On that paper, there were the letters CLP. How odd it is there. What does this CLP? She thought, and she unfolded it. This is, she did like this. And she caught in her hand. Just then, she heard her calling, "Seema, where are you?" "Here," said Seema to Arun, who was standing at the entrance of the cave. "I was looking for you." Yes, while she saw the paper and she took and she's reading, at that time, at that instant, she listened Arun calling her, "Seema, where are you?" Then she said, "Yes, I'm here, I'm searching for you." Then they both gathered at one place. So Arun asked, "What did you put in your hand, Seema?" He asked. "Yeah. It's nothing, just a piece of paper with CLP written on it," said Seema. "Yeah, it is nothing, it is a paper which is on which CLP is written." "Don't throw it, let me see it," said Arun. As he took the paper from her, he looked at it carefully and said, "See, if you look at the tonnage of the letter, which would be an ink and not a C." So Seema, while Seema is going to throw, it is not, it's just a paper on which CLP is written. So she was just, at that point she was going to, throw that paper. But she said, he said, "Who? Arun. Don't throw it. Let me see." Then Arun said, "Oh, this is the paper in which it was like a, how it was, he said. I think this was a paper which was torn. It was like a CLP. Yes. By looking at this, he said, see, look at the torn edge. It might be like E, I think. It is not C." He said to Seema. Then, what happened in C? "Do you think it could be help?" said Seema. Asked Seema. "Yeah, ELP is there. Any word which means this ELP in the sense? Help." So they thought, oh, here it is stone. In the sense, it might be E, not C. So maybe someone may be in the danger. Then, "Help, my goodness, someone is in trouble. We must find him," said Arun. They both thought that this is might be not CLP, it might be help. So they thought that someone was in danger. So they started to find him. So in next class, we are going to see who are in the danger and what type of an adventure these people are going to do. As children, till here, I hope you are clear. Yes, in next class, we go for the other part of the lesson.